Yeah, good morning, everybody. Let's continue with the MOSFET circuit. Yeah, MOSFET. In the triode region. Yeah, in the triode region for NMOS case, gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. Gate drain voltage is also larger than threshold voltage. This is the same as drain source voltage is less than VGS minus VTH. Then my current equation equal in the saturation region. Yeah, in the saturation region means current is saturated. So I eat a lot and happy. Current is saturated. So current doesn't change much with the drain source voltage. Okay, in this reason, gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. Gate drain voltage is less than threshold voltage, okay? So this is VDS is larger than VGS minus VTH. Now, in the cutoff region, gate source voltage is less than threshold voltage. Gate drain voltage is also less than threshold voltage. Drain current is zero, okay? So, CMOS inverter. Circuit notation is like that. So, if my input is logic 0, then my output will be logic high. Voltage-wise, see, if this input is 0 volt, my output voltage will be VDD. So logic is inverted. In circuit notation is like that. So I have a PMOS transistor and NMOS transistor here. So yeah, this is a VDD and this is a zero. Yeah, this is my output. This is my input. So this is VI, VO, okay. This NMOS substrate is connected to most negative potential in the circuit. PMOS substrate is connected to the most highest, most positive potential in the circuit to avoid that source drain junction to be turned on. Yeah, the IV characteristic of this CMOS inverter looks like this is NMOS threshold voltage. It remains when Vi is smaller than, less than. This is NMOS gate source voltage, which is Vi, right? PMOS source gate voltage, which is VDD minus Vi. Yeah. When Vi is less than threshold voltage, this NMOS FET is turned off. So it's VDD. This is VDD minus PMOS threshold voltage. PMOS threshold voltage is negative, right? So if I plot, This is called logic threshold voltage. Yeah, logic threshold. Yeah, logic threshold voltage is see, you know, if I plot I V O, this is my V O, right? So this is I. If I plot that I and the V O curve, see at the logic threshold, yeah, NMOS current must be. Yeah, this is I V O characteristic of NMOS. So I'm assuming my V I is same as logic threshold voltage. So gate source voltage of NMOS is constant. Okay, also gate source voltage of PMOS is a constant, right? Yeah, so PMOS current characteristic will look like that. That's IV characteristic of PMOS back, because PMOS source gate voltage is VDD minus VI. Okay. So because this is my operating point, because current must be same. Or NMOS and PMOS. So yeah, this will be my logic threshold voltage. Okay. Yeah. So you can see, NMOS works in a saturation. PMOS also works in saturation at the logic threshold condition. So I have a very high gain, right? Large slope. Yeah, because they operate in a logic threshold, I mean saturation. So yeah, I can calculate the logic threshold voltage easily. See, I don't have, let's go to here. Yeah, logic threshold voltage. Gate source voltage of NMOS is, yeah, that logic threshold voltage. Source gate voltage of PMOS is VDD minus logic threshold voltage. So NMOS current will be half mu NCOX W of L N logic threshold voltage minus NMOS threshold voltage, okay? So PMOS current will be half mu COX W of L P VDD minus VDD minus logic threshold voltage, which is the source gate voltage, right? So this is PMOS threshold voltage. PMOS threshold voltage negative, so I use the absolute notation here. Yeah, the current must be the same. So then I can find my logic threshold voltage is what? Just I think this is mu n C ox W of L. Is it right? Yeah. Same mu n C ox W of L n times PMOS logic threshold, PMOS threshold voltage plus mu PCOX W of LP times the same thing here. P times VDD minus PMOS logic threshold voltage. Yeah, here see, if my NMOS is very strong compared to PMOS, see, this is very large compared to this value. My logic threshold voltage will approach NMOS threshold voltage. If PMOS is stronger, it will go to VDD minus PMOS threshold voltage. So here, see, yeah, if my NMOS is very strong, this IV characteristic will move like that. Okay? This is a strong N. If PMOS is stronger, then my logic threshold voltage will shift. This is a PMOS is stronger. Logic threshold voltage will be increased. Okay? 강하다는 게 mu p cox w of l이 에 지금 요 경우 mu n cox w of l m보다 강하다는 거 크다는 거야. 그러니까 주로 W of L이죠. 모빌리티는 불변이니까. 그래서 okay, so if you make a parallel connection over here, PMOS twice, right? If you connect it like that, so logic threshold voltage will increase toward VDD.그건 정의인데 뭐 정의. 로직 스레쉬홀드 볼티지의 정의가 이 커브하고, 그러니까 그 로직을 갈라낼 때 같은 점을 기준으로 1제로를 갈라내고 싶잖아. 그래서 VO equal VI를 어떤 기준으로 삼는 거죠. 디지털 로직을 갈라내고 싶을 때. 오케이. Okay. So but however, say we have so in a DC characteristic like that. Yeah, this is a CMOS voltage transfer curve. So yeah, we have a logic threshold defined here. Yeah, VO equal VI. It defines my logic threshold voltage, right? However, we define the logic zero level by using those slopes. So this slope minus one. So the cross point, I mean the in this voltage transfer curve, we just find the slope. Yeah. So we can find the 2 points with a slope of minus one, right? So in this region, the gain is smaller than one. In this region, the gain, the slope is actually gain. Slope is larger than one. So in this region, my slope is smaller than one. So yeah, so this is VIL. We call this is VIH. Okay? So we define input voltage logic zero level here and logic high level there. So this is logic 0 input, logic 1 input. Okay? So in between, this is in the middle, it's undetermined. Okay, question. VTH는 아니고, VTH는 여기고, 여기가 VTH예요. VTH는 슬롭이 0일 때 아직 0이잖아요. 아, VIL이에요. 그렇죠. VIL. Input low level. input high level. When vi is smaller than input low level, it's counted logic 0 input. When vi is larger than vih, this is counted logic 1 input. Okay, come back quickly. Question? No? Alright, let's move. So, yeah, there is a sample hold operation, right? If you learn analog digital converter or something like that, there is a sample hold operation. So that sample hold operation is performed by switch. So MOSFET is a very good switch compared to BJT switch. Yeah, this is my sample hold circuit. This is the NMOS switch. So this substrate is connected to the most negative potential in the circuit. Yeah, for this one, if I see this gate voltage is that switching signal. Yeah, so my VIT is changing like that, arbitrarily with the time. So this is my VIT. If my VG is, say, for example, my VG changes from 0 to 5 volt. Okay, this is my VG. Okay. Yeah, then what is my output voltage here? Yeah, this VIT is sampled in capacitor. Okay. Then, yeah, when VG is this high voltage VDD, then see, this switch is on. Okay, this switch is on. So it follows VOT follows this input. Okay. When gate voltage is zero, this is turned off. So this switch, there is no current flow. Capacitor voltage remains the same. And when VT is on again, yeah, it will follow something like that. Okay. So this is I can say sample, and this is a hold operation. Okay, remains the same. How come this VOT follows the VIT when VG is VDD? This is VDD and this is 0 volt. Yeah, in this case, see, yeah, my VDD must be larger than threshold voltage. Yes, for example, VDD minus VTH is here. Yeah, this is VTH. My VIT is lower than, my VIT is lower than VDD minus VTH. So, gate source voltage of this NMOS is larger than threshold voltage, right? Okay. So, VGS is larger than threshold voltage. Yeah, the current may flow. However, at the DCOP, you can say this is a steady state. Or maybe I just say DCOP. Because of capacitor, there is no current, right? Current is zero. But gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. Then what will be my drain source voltage? So, I assume it's in triode. So I will assume it works in a triode, okay? Then my current equation, yeah, this is my current equation, and this current must be zero because of capacitor. So at the steady state, yeah, steady. Yeah, this case, I can say this is a steady state. Okay, steady state. Steady state. State. Steady state. Oh, maybe I can just say DC operating point. So at the DC operating point, the capacitor voltage, I mean capacitor current is zero. But gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. Then see, yeah, this is larger than threshold voltage. Then the only condition to satisfy this condition should be drain source voltage is zero. Okay.그렇지. 그래서 얘가 천천히 쫓아다니는데 그게 거의 아주 느리다고 생각해요. 느리다고. 오케이. Okay. So if VDS equals 0 volts, see my VOT must be same as VIT. So VOT follows VIT. 가정을 했죠. 가정을 해고서 봤더니 나중에 체크를 해야겠지. 그럼 VDS가 VGS 빼기 VTH보다 작으면 맞잖아요. 그리고 0V니까 저거를 만족시키는 거예요. VDS가 0V고 얘는 파지티브거든. 왜 0이 안 되냐? 0이 되지. 요 VDS가 0이니까. VDS가 0 되는 수밖에 없어. 요 조건 어디 갔죠? ID가 0이고 VGS가 VTH보다 크면은 이걸 만족시키려면 드레인 소스 전압이 0이 되는 수밖에 없어. 요건 플러스잖아, 그제? 얘를 0으로 만들어. 그러니까 VDS는 0이 아니다. 그러면 얘가 플러스니까 얘가 이제 그게 0이 되려면은 VDS는 EVGS 빼기 VTH가 되죠, 그죠? 그럼 되겠네. 그런데 트라이오드는 아니지. 세츄레이션에 가든지 무슨 딴 식을 써야 되잖아. 그 트라이오드란 가정이 안 맞죠? 오케이. 그걸 VDS는 0이 아니라고 주장하고 그게 지금 ID, VD를 하면은, VDS를 하면은, 근데 사실은 전류는 이렇게 되는데, 지금 한건요 조건을 만족시키는 걸 지금 생각해서. 근데 그건 없어. 그런 조건은. 트라이오드도 아니고 지금 아니잖아요. 그죠? 그래서 유일한 조건, 답은 VDS equal 0. 오케이? Alright. Yeah, you can easily find, see, when VGS equal, see, this, when, gate voltage is 0 volt, yeah, this will be cut off, ID equal 0, right? Then, this capacitor voltage must remain the same, right? So, it just keeps the output voltage at the same potential. Okay, question. Maybe 이 게이트 전압이 클락 시그널이거든. 게이트 전압을 VDD로 갔다가 0으로 갔다가 이게 클락이죠. 그게 샘플 클락이죠. 그죠? 게이트 전압이. 오케이. Yeah, see, this is NMOS, right? You can easily identify by this notation. Okay. Yeah, it just flows like that. There is no source notation here. Yeah, see, this is 10 mega ohm there. So I have just like that, right? You can see, because of this arrow, it means if this bulk junction is forward biased, the current will flow from P to N, right? So the substrate is P type. It is NMOS, right? So, you know, for the DC transfer curve of this one, will be see when VI equals 0, VO must be 0. Okay. So this is 0. Yeah, it will follow easily. But when, assume this threshold voltage is 2 volt, okay? This MOSFET. When it reaches 8 volt, then gate source voltage is 2 volt, right? When it becomes 9 volt, gate source voltage is only 1 volt, right? Less than threshold voltage. Then it just remain there. Okay? Actually, this is 10 minus 2, 8 volt. Okay? Yeah, what happens? See, assume VI equal 9 volt. Yeah, see, my VI equal 9 volt. Then, see, this voltage is just 1 volt, right? Oh, yeah, less than threshold voltage. It must turn off. How about that voltage? That voltage. This voltage, see? Yeah, see, assume because of the current, this is actually leakage current. Say, I am assuming this is my leakage current. Leakage. How can I write the leakage? Okay, can you read this one? No? Yeah, very difficult character, right? Leakage current. Leakage. Leakage current. Okay. So, you know, see, by this leakage current, this voltage drop between this node and that node must be threshold voltage. It must flow a little current. It must support the leakage current. So this voltage cannot be less than threshold voltage because it requires some leakage current, you know. Because see, this is 8 volt, right? There will be some current, right? Like 0.8 microamp leakage current flows through here. Gate source voltage must be slightly larger than threshold voltage. So in this case, this is 9 volt, this is a drain, this is a source. Yeah, almost cut off, right? That leakage current must supply from this VI. Question.뭐가 뭐보다 작다는 게 무슨 소리냐? 아, 그게 무슨 소리인지 모른다고? 그러니까 지금 보면은 이게 이제 트라이오든지 그렇게 전류를 흘린다고 치면요. 그래서 우리가 그려놓은 게 보통 뭐 이렇게 되는데, 여기에 지금 얘가 8볼트가 되든지 얘가 0볼트가 되면은 전류가 안 흐르겠죠. 그러면 이 게이트 소스 전압이 10볼트가 돼서 스레시홀드보다 커져가 뭐 전류가 흘러야만 되잖아, 그지? 그 0볼트는 말이 안 돼. 그래서 유일하게 말되는 조건이 얘가 스레시홀드 전압이 되면 되는데, 스레시홀드 전압보다 약간 커야 돼. 왜냐면 얘가 스레시홀드가 되면 요 전류가 약간 흐르니까, 그 조그만한 전류를 내가 흘려주려면은 요 스레시홀드보다도 약간 커져 있어야 돼. 약간만 커져 있으면 돼. 그래야 전류가 약간 흐르거든. 리퀴즈 전류가 약간 흐르거든. 최소화가 아니고 최소한의 리퀴즈가 흘러. 그러니까 전류가 약간은 흐른다는 거죠. 그러면 VGS가 VTH에 있으면 전류가 제로가 되잖아. 혹은 VGS가 VTH보다 작아지면 전류가 제로가 되죠. 그 VTH 플러스 델타만큼 VGS 이퀄 VTH 플러스 델타가 돼야 리틀 리퀴즈 전류를 흘려줄 수 있겠죠. 그래서 VGS를 VTH라고 하는 거야. 그렇죠. 컷오프에 가깝죠. 근데 그 VGS가 VTH보다 작아지면 완전 컷오프인데, 그러니까 요 리퀴즈 때문에 VGS는 VTH 플러스 리틀 델타가 있다는 거죠. 거의 0이지만. 그래서 VGS가 VTH에 있어야 된다는 거지. 작으면 안 되고. 오케이. Alright. Let's move to the PMOS switch. This is MOS switch, right? Yeah, for the PMOS switch. Yeah, my PMOS switch looks like that. This is my VI. And then I have my PMOS switch here. Say my substrate is connected to most highest potential. And then I have output capacitor here. So my gate is connected to 0 volt. Okay, this is 0 volt, the most negative potential. Yeah, you can say, you can put something like that notations, but yeah, wherever it is. So this is n-type substrate, right? Because of this arrow, my arrow must be there. Okay. This arrow represents there is n-type substrate. It is PMOS. Okay, PMOS. Yeah, see, when VI is larger than threshold voltage, PMOS. Actually, PMOS threshold voltage is negative. This is minus 2 volt, something like that. Okay, for example. Yeah, for example, my VI is 10 volt. VDD is 10 volt, okay? When VI is 10 volt, PMOS gate is 0 volt, right? So PMOS gate source voltage should be VG minus VI should be minus 10 volt, right? So it's less than threshold voltage. So my PMOS is turned on. Okay, it should conduct the current. This is same as gate source voltage larger than threshold voltage for MOS. Okay, yeah, there must be some current. So I assume, because gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage, I assume the transistor works in triode region. Then my current, see, I will use NMOS notation for simplicity. You just change all those polarity, current and voltage. 맞아. 이게 소스지. 부위, 그러면 상관없어. 소스가 여기부터도 되고, 저기부터도 되는데. 그러니까, 이게, 피모스 소스하고 드레인은 어떠냐 하면은, 전압이 높은 쪽이 피모스에서는 소스가 되겠죠. 그죠? 그 나중에 따져보면 이것도 바꿀 수도 있어. 근데 아무렇게나 붙여도 돼. 여기를 소스로 해놓고, 아니네 하면 나중에 이걸, 물론 노테이션 안 바꾸고서도, 여기를 소스라고 생각했는데, 아니면, 여기가 소스였구나. 전압이 바뀌면은. 그래서 지금 노테이션을 내가 이렇게 그려놓든지, 이렇게 그려놓든지 신경 안 써. 이거 잘못했네. 포텐셜이 더 높은 거. 예를 들어서, 이래놓고서도, 이렇게 했는데, 포텐셜이 얘가 1V, 2V가 되면은, 이쪽이 진짜 소스는 이게 되는 거죠. 노테이션, 이건 노테이션이야. 들어간다, 피모스라는 거야. 들어간다. 들어가기만 피모스. N모스는 나오면 N모스, 이게. 여기 N모스고, 얘는 피모스야. 어느 쪽에 붙여놔도 상관없어. 노테이션은. 오케이, okay. So let's continue. Yes, in this case, my VGS is minus 10 volt, so my drain current must be zero because of capacitor. So drain source voltage must be zero, right? So it should be 10 volt also. Okay? 퀘스천. No? Yeah. When VI is 0 volt, what happens? Yeah, my VI is 0. Then this source gate voltage is 0. Oh, it's less than threshold voltage. It must be turned off, right? Then, see, there is some leakage current connected between here and the VDD in this case. 10 volt VDD. 야, so in this case, threshold voltage minus 2 volt, right? So if it's 0 volt, it should be 2 volt here to make this gate source voltage to be minus 2 volt, which is threshold voltage, okay? Then it can flow little current, little current. This time, this is a source, right? Real source. This is a drain. So there is, because of 8-volt voltage drop there is a 0.8 microamp leakage current here. So this gate source voltage must remain at the threshold voltage. So when VI equals 0, VO is 2-volt. Okay? So the VIVO characteristic looks like, in this case, this is VO equal VI, so this is 10 volt, this is 10 volt, so it's fine. However, this is my threshold voltage, right? This is my PMOS voltage transfer curve. I mean, voltage transfer curve of PMOS switch. Question. Mm. 작지? 우선 VGS가 VTH보다 작으니까 이제 ON 되는 건 알잖아. ON, PMOS니까. 트라이오드 아니면 세츄레이션이겠지? 그 트라이오드로 가정했더니 맞았다는 거지. 트라이오드로 가정했더니 VGS가 0V가 되고 얘가 뭐저 VGS 빼기 VTH보다 크기가 작아지면은 얘가 트라이오드가 맞아요. 이 조건이 맞아 들어가. 세츄레이션식 하면은 안 맞아. 세츄레이션식을 열심히 해도 안 맞죠. 똑같이 그 단지 이 극성만 뒤집으면 생각하면 똑같아. 이걸 마이너스 10볼트로 생각하지 말고 10볼트로 생각하고 플러스 볼트, 얘를 플러스 2볼트라 생각하고 커런트 방향도 바꾸고 하면 다 똑같아져요. 오케이, any other question? So we'll skip those parts in the class, okay? Because we did it already. So here's we can say VI characteristic of those switches. VIC, this is 0, 0, 10 volt there. So, in a NMOS switch like that. So this is my NMOS. I have a resistor here. So this is my NMOS, right? VDD. Sorry. This is VI. So my PMOS. This is VDD. Yeah. Gate is VDD. There is my PMOS here. PMOS is just 0. This is VDD. Yeah, there is VDD. Yeah, this is my VO. Okay. Yeah, my NMOS characteristic is so it become flat at the 8 volt. Yeah, this is my NMOS. How about my PMOS? My PMOS thing, it's just like that. Okay, 2 volt, okay. So I have some gap here and there with either NMOS or PMOS. How about if I connect them together? Yeah, then see in this part my NMOS is on. Here my NMOS and PMOS is on. Here my PMOS is on. So I my either one is on or in entire region, right? So this is my CMOS switch, which is a parallel connection of NMOS and PMOS, okay? When you want to cut off, you just say this is a 0, this is a VDD. This is a PMOS, NMOS, right? Then you can perform the hold operation. Yeah, question.왜 이름을 스위치라 불렀나 거죠? 스위치? 지금 NMOS 게이트를 VDD, PMOS 게이트를 0으로 하면 뭐이 인타이어 리전에서 두개 중에 하나는 늘상 ON이죠. 그래서 ON 스위치. 근데 거꾸로 NMOS 게이트를 0V로 하고 PMOS 게이트를 VDD로 하면은 둘다 끊어져 버리죠. 그럼 OFF 스위치가 되죠. 그래서 ON OFF가 되는 거 아니에요. 그럼 샘플 홀드 오퍼레이션을 할수 있죠. ON 되면 샘플, OFF 되면 홀드. 오케이? 야, 퀘스천. 그 안정성이라면 NMOS는 이게 저 0 VDD를 커버를 못하고 이 위에서 잘려버리잖아요. 못 올라가잖아, 그제? 그리고 CMOS 스위치를 하면 다 올라가잖아요. 0 VDD까지 다 통과시켜 주잖아. 왜냐면 그 끄트머리를 VDD 쪽을 PMOS 스위치가 ON 시켜 줘가지고. 그래서 CMOS 스위치로 0에서 VDD까지를 VI를 다 통과시켜 주니까 큰 장점이죠. 오케이. 야, see, any other question? No? Okay, so, yeah, see, at the steady state, we can consider that switch as a resistor for small signal. Okay, so if I have a, for example, I have input signal. This input signal has some DC component. Yeah, this is my VI plus some small signal component. Okay, so it has, let's see. So this is my VDD, which is 10 volt. So this is my MOS switch. And then I have a sampling capacitor here. Yeah, for example, yeah, my VI equal 5 volt. So my VIT changes around 5 volt DC. Then for this small signal, I can consider this switch as a resistor, right? So see, this VI and then this is a resistor RC when it's turned on. So you can calculate this resistance. All right. See, you can easily calculate this resistance around by using this equation. Yeah, this resistance is around 1 over gm of saturation region. Okay, yeah, this is your chip. So, you know, we have, this is MOS, right? Is it PMOS? PN. Oh yeah, this is PMOS. This MOS. Yeah, what is this? PMOS, MOS. Yeah, you can easily make a CMOS inverter. Well, there is a CMOS inverter here already, right? So, one thing to note here is, say those, what is the number? Number 13. Is it 13? Number 14. Okay. Where is the MOS substrate? Oh yeah, number 7. Yeah. So, let's see. You know, this all those MOS substrate is connected to number 7 pin. So you have to connect this one. This one, the most positive potential. For the proper operation, okay? Otherwise, it doesn't work. Sometimes it will be crazy, okay? Okay, any question? Yeah, let's move to the MOSFET differential amplifier and digital logic gate. Okay. So, differential signal. Differential signal. What is a differential signal? Yeah, see, the Thevenin equivalent circuit looks like that. Yeah, see, this is my Thevenin signal, right? But differential signal consists of a combination of two such signals. see, my differential signal is something like, see, for example, combination of this signal is a differential signal, okay? Just a differential signal. It just contains a single information, okay? So usually, this signal, the information is here. See, there are two components. So common mode and differential mode signal. See, common mode signal is just average of those two. Differential signal is just difference between the two. So we just put information here, okay? Information. Common mode signal, we don't use the information because see, the noise is mostly common mode. For example, say I have a sensor here. Say it may be a temperature sensor or whatever. Yeah, anyway, I have my sensor here. See, I just connect this one into long line, and then there is some measurement circuit far away. In between, there is thunders and lightning. Okay? So those are common mode noise is induced there, but that difference component, from the different component, I can extract the desired information very accurately. That's the advantage of the differential signal, okay? So we don't use a common mode, just the differential mode, okay? Yeah, question.보통 그렇게 똑같아요. 그러니까 라인이 길면은 여기서 빵 치면은 같은 값이 유기가 돼요. 밖에서 어떤 공통 노이즈가 들어오면은 뭐 보통 여기서 그렇게 번개만 얘기하는데 캐패시터 카플링도 보통 이렇게 같은 값으로 들어가요. 그래서 캐패시터 카플링에 예를 들어서 요것들이 C1, C1, C2, C2가 이렇게 갔다면은 여기 큰 노이즈 소스가 옆에 지나갔어요. 1000V짜리 노이즈 소스가 지나갔어요. 캐패시터 카플링이나 인덕티브 카플링이 같은 값으로 들어가. 길게 선이 지나가고 있으면 커먼 모드죠. 그래서 나중에 여기 보면은 얘는 빼기래요, 빼기. 디퍼렌셜 모드만 가져와요. 카먼 모드는 거의 0이야. 카먼 모드 게인은 거의 0이 되죠. 그게 자동 증폭기를 쓰는 이유예요. 디퍼렌셜 신호만 뽑아가요. 오케이? So, 디퍼렌셜 앰플리파이어. 디퍼렌셜 앰플리파이어. Just extract that component, okay? So this is VO and V1, V2. This is differential mode voltage gain plus common mode voltage gain there. But usually this common mode voltage gain is almost zero. Differential mode voltage gain is very large, very large. Okay, very large. So we can neglect that part, okay? So differential amplifier, differential, that's what the uses of differential amplifier, okay? How can I write? This is my differential amplifier. It just amplify differential component only. Okay, how can I do that? Say we can do it by using a transistor using a current source here at the common source node. Okay. Yeah, this is my differential amplifier. See, for example, yeah, this is a current source, okay? Yeah, if my V1 equal V2, you know, because this source node is common, gate source voltage are the same, then if it works in the saturation, if I assume it works in a assume saturation, yeah, that ID should be the same, because you know, in saturation the current equation equal basically function of gate source voltage only, right? If we neglect the channel length modulation effect, okay? So if gate source voltage are the same, current are the same, yeah, my VO1, VO2 should be, you know, this current should be half ISS, half ISS, right? So this is a drain resistor. So my this should be VDD minus half ISS times RD. They are the same. So in this case, my differential output voltage is zero. Okay. If I increase VI and V1 and V2 by the same amount, yeah, it doesn't change, right? Yeah. See. Yeah. When see, this is 10 volt, for example. This is minus 10 volt. Okay. When V1, V2 equal 0, yeah, my output is 0. V1, V2 equal 5 volt, or maybe 2 volt, doesn't change, right? My common mode output doesn't change at all. Question? No? Differential output voltage, VOD, OD, differential output. 안 하지? 트라이오드 있으면 저 VDS 드레인 소스 전압이 있어서 이 스토리가 안 맞죠. 그래서 우리가 얘하고 정할 때 얘가 세츄레이션에 동작하도록 이렇게 다 조정을 해놔요. 그래야 그게 게인도 커요. 세츄레이션에서 전압이 이렇게 커져요. Okay, what's the small signal voltage gain here? Yeah. So this is my most differential pair. Okay, what is yeah, for example, yeah, this is RD 10 volt minus 10 volt. Okay, this minus 10 volt. For example, yeah, this is I assume this is what? This is 2 milliamp. Okay, so this is 5K. Is this 5K? Yeah, okay, this is, I assume, 5K, 5 kilo, okay? So I want to plot VO1 first. Yeah, VO, it is symmetric. How can I write it? Oh, yeah. This is V1 minus V2, okay? So when V1 minus V2 is 0, this is 0, yeah, what's my V01? Yeah, my V01, this is V01. My V01 is, see, if it's 0, gate source voltage are the same, right? Current are the same, so this current will be 1 milliamp each. Then this voltage 5 volt drop there, so this should be 5 volt, right? Oh yeah, my V1 is only 5 volt. Then, see? Yeah, here see, at this state, you know, the this ID1 equal 1 milliamp. This is because it works in the saturation. Yeah, see, I can define this gate overdrive voltage. You see, for example, yeah, this is what? This is 2 milliamp per volt square, just I assume. Then, my gate source voltage at this condition should be just 1 volt, right? So, here, my gate source voltage is, so if my threshold voltage is 2 volt, my gate source voltage is 3 volt, okay? So, yeah, this is 3 volt. Oh, no, no, no. See, if I assume this is 0, or 3 volt, so it should be minus 3 volt here, okay? When V1, V2 equals 0. Question. No. Okay. Then, you see, I increase, this V2 is 0. If I increase this V1 voltage to 1 volt, what happens? Okay, so here, my V1 equal 1 volt, V2 is still 0 volt, okay? So I am here. This is V1 minus V2 equal 0 volt. What happens? See, in this state, VGS1 minus VGS2 equal 1 volt. Is it right? Because my source are the same, so you know, the voltage drop between here and there is VGS1 minus VGS2, right? This is only 1 volt, okay? Then, see, in this case, see, then this 2 milliamp current flows through there, 0 milliamp flows through there, okay? See, okay, the second line. Hey, Dawson one, you three. You three all sleeping. That guy is still sleeping. From the Monday class and Wednesday class, you know, all those guys are just sleeping. What's the problem? Huh? Okay? Careful. Alright, you guys careful. Alright. So here, see, in this condition, just 1 volt and 0 volt, somehow this all of this current flows through here. You know, see, I'm still assuming all those M1 and M2, those transistor works in the saturation region. Okay, that's my assumption. Then see, in this state, so you know, I have two conditions here, this condition and also some of those current are 2 milliamp, right? So if I write this is 2 milliamp per volt square, VGS1 minus VTH square, this is 2 volt, right? Plus 2 milliamp times VGS2 minus VTH square is 2 milliamp, right? So this condition is satisfied only when this becomes 2 volt and this becomes 0 volt, okay? We can verify that, okay? If this becomes 2 volt, you know, this 2 and 2 milliamp, this is 2 square is what? Uh-oh, am I make some mistake? Oh, sorry. Yeah, this doesn't happen. This happens square root 2 volt, okay? Square root 2 volt. See? So, yeah, this happens not 1 volt. This happens 1 VGS square root 2 VGS minus VTH. Okay. This happens square root 2 volt, okay? See? This happens square root 2 volt. So, you know, when VGS1 minus VGS2, which is the same as V1 minus V2, this becomes square root 2 times VGS minus VTH at the steady state at this point, which is 1 volt, right? So when differential input voltage is square root 2 times VGS minus VTH at this at the steady state, then this becomes 2 milliamp, this becomes 0 milliamp. So my VO1 is reduced to just, it may not work properly, but it drops to what? Drops to 0 volt, right? 5 volt. See, this is drops to 0 volt, something like that. So I have to change something here, okay? So actually I have to change some bias point. All right, let me do it clean up. So this is differential input voltage, and then my VO1 is yeah, this is 0 square root 2 VGS minus VTH. This is VGS minus VTH at this point, okay? So here, this is square root 2 VGS minus VTH. So this is 10 volt, this is 10 volt minus 5K times 2 milliamp. Yeah, this is 0. So I just assume the transistor works all saturation in all those regions. Okay. So this is VO1. VO2 is similarly, yeah, something like that. VO2. So my linear operation range of differential input voltage is just. This slope is my voltage gain. Yeah, this is only GMRD. Okay, that's my differential mode voltage gain. Common mode voltage gain is 0. Question.이거 아니었나? 이거였다. 이걸 할까? 이게 좋아요? 요거, 아니, 변해야지. 지금 내가 요 전압을 조금 잘못 잡아가 이 트라이오드에 빠져버리는데, 요 전압 시작점을 내가 조금 다르게 할게요. 그러면 요 상태가 어떻게 되냐면은, V1 빼기 V2는 스퀘어루트 2볼트예요. 스레셔홀드 전압은 2볼트라 그랬고, 원래 원래 지금 이걸 내가 저 영영이라 안 하겠어요. 왜냐면 이거 약간 저 전압이 세츄레이션을 넣기 위해서 원래 오리지널이 같을 때 이게 마이너스 5볼트라 그러겠어요. 마이너스 5볼트. 그래도 지금 저기 요두 개가 같으니까 요 점이 있죠. 그러면 이게 마이너스 8볼트가 돼 있어야 돼. 요 상태에서. 오케이? 그런데 지금 내가 이걸 저 마이너스 5 얘를 마이너스 5 플러스 스퀘어루트 2로 올리고 얘는 마이너스 5볼트를 그냥 뒀어요. 그럼 어떻게 되냐면은 이게 저 이제 1볼트가 아니고 스퀘어루트 2볼트가 돼야 돼요. 그러면 얘가 스퀘어루트 2볼트가 돼야 되니까 얼마가 되나? 그러니까 지금 VGS1으로 말할 것 같으면은 VGS1 마이너스 VTH가 스퀘어루트 2볼 아까는 1볼트였잖아. 1볼트 원래는 그제? 아까 1볼트 아니었나? 아까 1볼트예요. 1볼트. 오리지널이나. 그러니까 요 상황에서 블루 상황에서는 VGS 빼기 VTH가 1볼트에서 둘 다. 그래야 이 전류들이 저 1mA씩 됐어요. 요게 1mA가 되려면 요게 2mA라 그랬잖아요. 그러면 얘가 1볼트였어. 오케이? 근데 이 상황에서는 얘가 스퀘어루트 2볼트가 됐어. 그러면 얘는 2볼트니까 VGS1으로 말할 것 같으면은 2볼트 플러스 스퀘어루트 2볼트가 되죠. 그러면 얘에서 빼줘야죠. 빼주면 얼마가 되나? 마이너스 8. 얘가 마이너스 7 마이너스 스퀘어루트 2인가? 어쨌건 그렇게 되면요. 얘가 마이너스 7 마이너스 스퀘어루트 2인가? 이렇게 돼요. 그래서 이 전압이 어떻게 되냐? 그때 따져보면은 이 전압이 거의 스레시홀드 전압이라 해야 되는데 왜 스토리가 안 맞노? 잠깐만요. VGS가 스퀘어루트 2 스레시홀드에 딱 붙어 있어야 되는데 잘안 맞네. 마이너스 7이면 스토리가 맞는데 마이너스 7인가 보다. 자 따져보자. VGS 그러니까 VGS1이 스레시홀드 플러스 스퀘어루트 2가 돼야 되고 VG는 마이너스 5 플러스 스퀘어루트 2가 되잖아요. 그죠? 그러면 VS로 말할 것 같으면은 VS가 얼마죠? VG1 빼기 2 빼기 스퀘어루트 2가 되므로 마이너스 7 되겠네. 얘가 마이너스 7이래요. 마이너스 8이 아니고. 그러면 얘가 스레시홀드 전압인 2볼트에 딱 붙어 있어. 그래서 전류가 이제 그때부터는 오른쪽 전류는 안 흐르게 돼요. 예, 퀘스천. 노? Alright, let's continue.